the Center of Forest Research and Development at the Ministry of Environment and Forestry, Banjarbaru Environmental and Forestry Research and Development Institute, and the Mushroom Initiative carried out technology transfer activities for mycorrhizal application for the Great Peatland Restoration, which was held on 17 February 2020 in Pilang Village, Jabiran Raya District, Pulang Pisau Regency, Central Kalimantan. The activity begins with an introduction from Professor Maman Turjaman as project leader of PMI Indonesia. In his speech, Professor Maman Turjaman conveyed an overview that in their natural habitat, there is an association of mutualism relationship between plant roots and mycorrhizae. In the opening remarks delivered by the acting head of Banjarbaru Environmental and Forestry Research and Development Institute, Mrs. Rahayu Setiawati, it was conveyed that the Environment and Forestry Research and Development Institute, in collaboration with the Bogor Forest Research Center, had carried out its activities related to mycorrhizae application, especially for peatland type seeds, with the hope that this training, the knowledge and experience gained, can be useful for the people of Pilang Village, especially for the Bijau Farmer Group. Dr. Marinus Kristiadi Harun asked the first speaker with the theme Utilization of Peatland Resources, said that there are potential resources in peatlands, including understory trees, trees that can be used by the community to earn income. These include ferns and shrubs on peatlands that can be processed into animal feed. There is also purun, Eleocharis dulcis, besides being used as plate, it can be used as an environmentally friendly straw material. The next material is mycorrhizae and application for plant growth, delivered by Triwira Yuwati. In her presentation, informed in general about mycorrhizae, the types of mycorrhizal and mycorrhizal function among others as growth buster, protect plants from pathogens, protect from environmental stress, improve soil aeration, and increases the absorption of plant nutrients from the soil post pores. The last speaker is a technique of making seeds that was delivered by Sampang. In his presentation, it was informed that seedlings can be made generative from seed, vegetative like cuttings, graft, grafting, etc., and from natural tillers. Presented methods from seedlings of each seed origin, winning media, winning seed selection, nursery maintenance, until the seed are ready to be planted in the field. The next event was a practical session in which example of the types of mycorrhizae, both ecto and endomycorrhizae, were presented. The event was closed by planting 300 Soria Balangeran seeds with a 3x3 meter spacing in Ibu Nurul's garden.
Nama saya Ibu Jenta, saya ketua kelompok Pilang Hijau yang beranggotakan 50 orang, bergerak di bidang usaha karet. Tetapi kelompok kami tidak hanya bergerak di kelompok karet dan sengon, juga di kelompok kami ditanami buah-buahan, ada juga yang memelihara ikan, ada yang ternak, dan menanam tanaman palawija, sayur mayur, di sela-sela, di halaman, pekarangan, maupun di sela-sela kebun karet kami. Tanaman sengon di lahan kami tidak sesuai dengan yang kami harapkan. Kami mau tanaman sengon kami mau diganti dengan tanaman pohon jenis blangiran. Harapan kami adanya pelatihan cara penanaman atau jenis pohon yang cocok di lahan kambut. Dan kami juga berharap dengan ditanami tanah kosong sehingga lahan kami terjaga dari kebakaran. Dan kami hasil kayu bisa kami manfaatkan untuk penambahan ekonomi kami atau tabungan kami.